are one of the biology topic in today's class. So before going to our class, just I want you to know how comfortably we are all living. Isn't it? We are living comfortably day by day, our comforts will be increasing and we are happy with that. But still we are aspiring for the more and more things to make our life comfortable. Can you name few things which makes our life comfortable? One by one. Which are the, what are the things we use? Yes. Yes.
Food.
Water. Air.
Sunlight.
Yes. Clothes. See, now you said sunlight, food, water. Where do we get all this? In nature. So we will call all these things are found in nature. For this we call it a system. What is a system? Very good. Ecosystem. Isn't it? And sun, you said, even though it is found in the nature, we call set of stars, star and planets together as one system. What is that?
Solar.
Very good. Solar system. Right. So now you came to know ecosystem, which is making our life comfortable, as well as we have solar system, directly, indirectly, we are depending upon it. You see, these two systems are created by man? Surely no. That, what we call for that?
Natural
system. What are the other systems apart from natural systems makes our life comfortable?
Man-made.
Which are those?
Clothes.
Okay, fine.
Buildings.
Washing machine. daily utensils. Fan, fridge. Electrical gadgets. Computer. Cell phone.
Pen.
Yes?
Pens.
Are the stationary material which we use in our education system. Now you said computer. Now computer, which part of the computer makes you to work comfortably? Any one particular part?
Keyboard.
Is it keyboard only is enough?
CPU
is required. Is it only keyboard and CPU is enough?
Monitor.
Then?
Mouse.
So now, in order to work with computer, do you require all these parts? Can we call computer as a system instead of one particular gadget? So we call computer system. Who made the system?
Charles.
Okay, you are saying that human. So in general we can say man-made system. Like that is a cell phone. Means of communication, right? So this communication, is it only cell phone is a means? Is it only cell phone we make use in order to communicate?
Landline.
We have the landline phone also. Then? Writing letters, very good. Poster, through poster. Newspaper.
TV. Facts.
Facts. TV, mass media. All this will be a means of communication. So in order to communicate one to another and one to many, we want others, we will make use one other time depending upon our requirement. Again, this is the system which has been created by man for his comfortable. So when we look at these systems in our society, we have natural systems as well as we have man-made systems to make human beings' life more and more comfortable, right? At the same time, leave the society as such, leave the environment as such. Think of your own individual now. Come back to your own individual, now you are outside, isn't it? We are ecosystem and we are in transport system, our communication system, our computer system. Now consider you yourself as an individual. Think, do we have some of the system just like this, how it will operate outside, also makes our life better. Do we have, do we have some systems? Heart. Is it heart is a system? Yeah, you are right. Yes, you know, you said no, computer, keyboard, monitor, CPU, just like that. Heart is the one part of one system.
Animal.
You see, animal, kingdom animal, animals also, plants also, all the living organisms will have one or the other system within. Can you name few systems of such kind?
Producers,
ecosystem again, plants. Within the plant, I'm asking. Shall I give one here? The food you said is a basic requirement. When we eat a food, is it simply by when you keep in the mouth and you will get an energy?
Digestive
system, right? We are a digestive system. Then, respiratory system. Excretion system. Now, one system is coming out, right? Skeletal system. Yes? Nervous system. Exactly. Think many more. If you keep listing all, we'll have circulatory system. Okay. And endocrine system. Like this, if you keep listing out, we'll get many more systems. Are they man-made? Surely not. They are all within us. They are all the natural systems. They all function in order to be healthy human being. Right? So now I will be giving you, as you have listed out some of the systems, and there are organs which are associated with it. For example, as you said, heart is an organ associated to one system. And when it comes to digestive system, there are organs which are associated. Just like in artificial system, like computer, there are different parts. Among the different parts, one part may be major role in place. Like in a computer also, one part plays a major role. Heart and soul of the computer, we say, which is the CPU, right? Central processing unit. Just like that, even in our body, with all these different systems, we have particular the main organ which are involved in it. So I will be giving you the worksheet now. In that there will be list of organ systems. In that there are organs which are being listed out. You need to match which organ is the main in the particular specific organ system. Distribute among yourself. First do individually. Then if you want, you discuss with your friends and let me know the answers. You can share this. If any extra people. Complete, just raise your hands. The same thing I projected here. Just do your finish your work, then we'll go for one by one. You can draw your lines or you can put a number, whichever is convenient for you. Completed? Those who are not completed? Try it. You might have studied in your earlier classes. Right. Most of the time we bother for outside systems, but within us we have so many systems, right? Now you need to know which was the main organ so that we can take care of it. Completed? We'll go by one by one now. Yeah, the first one I have given you skeletal system. Which is the main organ?
Bones.
Good. The second one, muscular system,
muscles.
Have you all done, right?
Yes.
The next one, transport system, also called circulatory system,
heart.
And fourth one, respiratory system,
lungs.
Digestive system,
intestine.
Intestine. Even though in digestive system, all the organs play a role, but intestine is the one where complete digestion takes place. And then nervous system?
Brain.
Now, I don't want mass answers. Excretory system, can you name? This is the main organ? Very good.
Kidney.
And endocrine? Give us a. Endocrine?
Glands.
Okay, you might have heard of here and there diseases, but anyway, you are not going to study in today's class. Let us see later. How about this? Anyway, I think most of you have done your answers. Just graph check. Those who are not done, correct it. Fine? Yes. Now, as I said, the transport system, the main organ is heart. Which are the other parts or other components of transport system will be required to complete the system?
Blood.
Blood vessels, see blood vessels?
Nerves.
Nerves. Is it required for the circulatory system? It is required for the nervous system. Any other?
Pump.
Yes?
Pump.
Okay. It will be one of the function. Which is other requirement is limb. These are the four requirements for circulatory system. function. Blood,
blood vessels,
heart and limb. So now in today's class, let us learn about the structure of heart as one of the organ of main organ of circulatory system or a transport system.
Covered by
double layer and tell you of the double layer covered by pericardia. Okay, this pericardium is the double layer which protects the heart. As it is a muscular organ, will be covered by this double layer. So, which protects the muscular organ? How it protects? It is also muscular organ, heart. Again, this is also muscular layer. How do you expect it will cover? Like protect? One layer, again one more layer. Is it will have to give the best protection? Yes, we all have. See, now one plastic polythene you might have covered, you kept something. One more polythene you'll cover. Can we expect 100% guarantee it will be protected? No, this will have one more strategic planning here. This double layer pericardium has been filled with one fluid. What we call the fluid? In the pericardial fluid. Just I'll show you how it may function. Consider, even though it is not a heart, just imagine it may be a heart. It is a muscular organ within. Okay, so this was a layer outside. Can consider as what is the layer? Pericardium. So between the space, what is formed from the heart and the pericardium, outer layer, inner layer and outer layer, two layers there, no? So between that there is a fluid, which is called pericardial fluid. What may be the significance of this pericardial fluid that I want each one to think? There are two layers. Between the two layers, the fluid formed, that fluid we call pericardial fluid. What may be the significance of this fluid? Skin. This is muscle, muscular layer. Within, skin is outer part of the body. This is the largest organ. I am not talking about skin now. Consider heart is within the thoracic cavity. Thoracic, with the heart, it will be covered by two layers. Within the two layers, in between the two layers, there is a fluid. This fluid is called pericardial fluid. What is the function of this pericardial fluid? To save? How do it will save? Just imagine now. That will go later. That will go. Now consider, this is a heart now. Heart. Now, if I put you in a cover, empty cover, if I give it a handler, and if I ask you to press, is it easy to press? Within, it's no water. Consider no water. Just it is inside the organ and outside only polythene cover. It will be covered with that, very near to it. So if I ask you to press, is it easy to press?
Sure.
You are not getting what I am saying. Consider now, this was the pericardial layer. Within that, heart is formed. Okay, I will ask you to press. Press it? Press it, no? Can you able to press? No, you may not harm the organ, but you can able to press till to the layer of the heart. Isn't it? Can you do same thing with this? Press? Can you touch? Yes, easily you can touch the organ, but here? It is not so easy for to touch. Can anyone want to test? Touch this, press this and press this. You want to press the organ. Again here. You can't press because there is a fluid. This fluid protects the heart when there is a heartbeat, as you said, no? We'll go back to heartbeat out. So when there is a heartbeat, there is continuous like contraction, relaxation of the heart muscles. So when they contract and relax, there may be damage when it will keep touching with the outer layer. So to protect that, this pericardial fluid helps. Got it now? Significance of pericardium and pericardial fluid. Okay, so far, we learn the location, then size of the heart, and heart is a muscular organ which is covered by double layer pericardium, Between the layers, there is a fluid.
Pericardial fluid.
It protects the heart. Okay. Now let us see the internal structure of heart.
Ventricle.
Similarly towards right?
Right
ventricle. That's it. Right? Copy the correct spellings if you don't know. If you couldn't follow, ask me. Left ventricle, right ventricle. Finish. And before this, we learned one part of the heart, which is the outer part? Pericardia. Isn't it? So this will be a, the outer layer will be called pericardia. So this layer will be filled with some fluid. It is called pericardial fluid. Okay, clear? Now, this is the left side. Between the left atrium and left ventricle, there is a part of the, there is a part which will call bicuspid valve. It will be like this. Bicuspid valve. Valve means, you might have seen like when you pump the water to the upstairs tanks, and if you want to control the flow to the particular house or particular tap, you may close or you may open, no? Well, it's just like that, which will regulate the flow either opposite or vice versa, whatever they may be, either through or flow, it will maintain. So that is all. This valve will be called bicuspid. Are you all taking off? Valve, V-A-N. Similarly, there should be something towards right side also, right? Between the right atrium and right ventricle. There should be. When it will be this side, this side also, there should be. Again, there is a valve which we call tricuspid. Tri means what?
Three.
Bi means?
Two.
Okay. So now, here there will be, this will be the thing. So we call tricuspid valve. How many parts you have got now? Yes. What you are writing is your heart. Be careful. You are writing in your own way. Check it. Something tilting should be shown. No. Yeah. This side. Right side. Right. Yeah. Good. Those are the better. Slightly towards that side. Okay, fine. Now, because we have given the last sketch. What is the major function of heart? Very good. Pumping blood. So, we will
call. Gives a good blood to our body pumps.
It gives the? True blood. Okay, it is giving the true blood, taking away the impure blood also is one of the function. Mainly, it is a pumping heart. Just like how we pump water to our tank to some, from the sump, just like that. This muscular organ, heart functions as a pumping organ. Instead of calling the heart is a muscular organ, we can call it as pumping muscular organ. Are you getting clarity? Why we call it a pumping organ? It will keep continuously pumping the blood from the heart to the other parts or other parts to the heart, it will keep flowing. So we call it as a pumping heart. In order to pump the blood to the different parts of the body or to carry it from the different parts of the heart, what do we need? Vessels we need. So just like our machine, like a pumping machine, where we tubes we use, pipes we use in order to pump the water up and down, isn't it? Just like that, here also we have something called vessels. I mean, just like a tubes. This those tubes which helps to circulate the blood from organ to different parts, from different parts of the heart. So we call blood vessels. Then what are the different types of blood vessels which you are aware? Blood vessels, there are two types, major. Yeah, yeah, fine, here. Blue color, red color. You have seen everywhere, you have seen blue color and red color. Do you think really that there will be blue color and red color blood vessels? imaginary. It is an imaginary just to make our understanding clear. See here. And here we have green also, don't get worried. And cellular. So now this, consider these are the two. What are these two? It is the structure of heart. Heart, what I showed, internal is a model. Now these two, there are two parts up and there are two parts down. What we call for the two? Three chambers. Left ventricle, right ventricle. Overall ventricles. So ventricles and here two auricles. Blood will be taken away from the ventricles and again blood will be got it back to the auricles from the different vessels. One, as you said, one is blue color, another one is red color vessels. What we call for blue color? Yes? Let me, whatever you want to tell me, so that you will be able to tell you, to make it correct. Vena cava, very good. Somewhere you got that term, vena cava. We have two vena cavas, right? Superior, very good. Superior vena cava and
inferior
vena cava. These are the two blood vessels. Which carries? Blood. We'll see which kind of blood later. Okay, otherwise, the blood vessels are of two types majorly. One is arteries and veins. Okay, arteries and veins. Always arteries carries the pure blood. Always carries. There are very specific nature also. And veins carries the impure blood or deoxygenated blood, which you call blue. We'll see. Very good. Consider now. So this was the chambers. Now we'll see which chamber collects the pure blood, which collects the impure blood. Now left side of the heart collects always pure blood. Collects as well as pumps. Collects and pumps, two type of terminology of left heart always collects pure blood and pumps pure blood. Whereas right side always collects impure blood and pumps out impure blood. What is meant by pure blood and impure blood? Is it you are mixing something in it to make it impure? Then what is exactly meant by pure and impure? Pure blood is nothing but oxygenated blood. Got it? Pure blood is nothing but oxygenated blood. Impure blood is nothing but deoxygenated blood. Or the blood filled with carbon dioxide. Okay, now we'll see from where it collects the pure blood and from where which part of the body forms the pure blood. Now, this is the right, left chamber, upper chamber collects the blood from the lungs through pulmonary veins. Are you getting? Yeah. Now, this side mark it. See here, there are blood vessels which are called pulmonary veins. From where it comes from? These are all pulmonary. V-E-I-N-S, pulmonary veins. Clear? Yeah. Pulmonary veins. Which are taken, which carries the blood to the heart. Okay, from where?
Lungs.
From lungs. Then what kind of blood it is? It is taken from the lungs. Pure blood, which is also called
oxygenated
blood. Okay, now just imagine blood came and filled into left atrium. It was being filled up. We'll consider now left atrium filled with the blood which is of pure or oxygenated, which is being carried back from the lungs. At the same time, right side also should be filled. Okay, your friend already said there are two blood vessels which are called superior vena cava, inferior vena cava. Two blood vessels which carries the blood to the which is this part? Right atrium. So the same is called superior vena cava. Vena cava. Got it? Similarly, this will carry the blood from the upper part of the body, which is oxygenated or deoxygenated?
Deoxygenated.
connected in your blood from the upper side of the body. At the same time, from the lower parts of the body, there is another blood vessel
which we call inferior
vena cava. This will have the connection here. Imagine from the back side, so here will be opening. This we call inferior vena cava. I write IVC. Here superior vena cava, inferior vena cava. Got it? Inferior INFERIOR. Are you getting?
Yes.
Any confusion? Yeah, please. Donating the blood.
अब ब्लड का है ना ब्लड तो ऑक्सीजन क्या है ऑक्सीजन
तो व्हेन वी टेक द ब्लड ट्रांसफ्यूजन यू आर आस्किंग इन केस इफ यू डोनेट द ब्लड टू द अदर पर्सन फ्रॉम यू इट वोंट एम्प्टी द ब्लड देयर बी नियरली इन अ नॉर्मल इंडिविजुअल दैट 4 टू 5 लीटर्स ऑफ ब्लड यू विल बी डोनेटिंग ब्लड अप्रोक्सीमेटली 350 ml ओके विद इन अ मंथ यू आर गोइंग टू रीजनरेट योर ब्लड दैट टू न्यू ब्लड विद फाइव बेस्ट क्वालिटीज Same more blood over, no? If you get a new blood generated, you'll be more and happy and more angry. So keep donating as you reach your particular age. I think I'm sure that now nobody will take blood from you all. But if you reach a particular age, okay, you'll be capable of donating. If you donate blood, we are giving part of our blood. Just 350 ml. In that way, we won't lose it anything. Got it? Okay. Now, this from the superior and inferior, if your blood will into the right, atria. Fine. Now these two have been filled. After filling, what will increase? Pressure will increase, right? As the pressure increases, simultaneously they will contract. Contracting the cells, then come closer. When they come closer, pressure increases. These two valves open. Are you getting? When these two valves open, the blood flows from the auricles to ventricles. Now ventricles is going to be filled completely. Even this ventricles are going to fill with the blood which has come from the auricles, right? Okay. When this blood has to go now, it has to go how? Yes. From here it starts circulating, taking away the blood from the heart to the other parts of the lungs. So the left side pure blood, this is the left side, right? From here, it will go to the different parts of the body. Pure blood, now this is pure or not? From the left ventricle, it is a pure blood. We have many more connections like this. So from here, it will carry the blood to the different parts of the body. Are you getting? Then what we call this blood vessel? Aorta. A-O-R-T-A. Aorta is the blood vessel. Are you taking down the small notes? Large notes, are you making down? Make a note of it in a mirror. Aorta is the blood vessel, carries the pure blood from left ventricle to different parts of the body. Okay, now, even here there is a blood which is being filled, which is impure blood. Where this blood has to go? It has to get purified, right? Where it purifies? Lungs. Exchange of gases takes place. We breathe in and breathe out, right? We take oxygen, we give out the carbon dioxide in that way. And in alveoli, there is exchange of blood. Gases takes place. That means pure is going to be converted into impure, impure to the pure. So now in the heart, lungs, here there is a blood vessel which will be carrying blood from the it will have the two divisions. Why you know? One part will carry to the right side, right lung. Another one carries the blood to the left lung. So in that way, this is the blood vessel carries the blood, impure blood away from the heart but to the lungs, not to the different parts of the body. Then what will be the, what we call for this vessel? Pulmonary artery. This will be the blood vessel which carries the impure blood to the lungs. This is called pulmonary. Pulmonary by now, you know the spelling, right? See, I will tell you here V, but here artery. Artery, A-R-T-E-R-Y. Clear? Are you able to form the structure of heart now? Yes or no? If not, I will try to explain once again. But I want each one of you to clear it. The same parts which I showed here. Mainly, these are the two. See now, this has too many divisions where it carries the blood from the right ventricle to the lungs to oxygenate and to get purified in our by exchanging the gases. Whereas this was the only blood vessel which is called aorta, carries the pure blood from the ventricle to the different parts of the body. So two major blood vessels. Which are the two major blood vessels? Aorta. Two major blood vessels. In general, aorta, pulmonary veins, pulmonary artery, superior, inferior, vena cava, we have. In general, what are all this? Either arteries or? Arteries or? See here.
Veins.
Yes, either arteries or they may be veins. Got it? I said one statement. All the arteries carry pure blood in general. Are you getting what I'm saying? All the blood vessels, two types, arteries and veins, all the arteries carry pure blood. All the veins carry pure blood. There is there, but there is one unique nature. I think I want you to find here. See here? Aorta limb, here pulmonary veins, and here pulmonary artery. Only in these two, the only vein carries pure blood is pulmonary vein. This will be that pretty, you need to know. The only veins carries pure blood is pulmonary veins. The only. Otherwise, all the veins carries impure. But only this will carry the pure blood. At the same time, see here, the only arteries carries impure blood. Two colors indicates impure, right? Which is taking the blood away from the heart to the lungs, which is impure. So this is the only artery carries the impure blood. Otherwise, in general, all the arteries carries pure blood and veins carries impure blood. You got to know what is pure and what is impure. Okay, so now when these two chambers fills, blood flows to the heart ventricles by opening of this valves. So when this is filled, pressure will increase and they will come contract. Whereas this valves is there, no, they prevent the backflow of blood. Just imagine when these two contracts, this ventricles, if they contract and blood again goes back to the heart, because what happens? The blood won't go away from the heart only. It will be playing there only. And all our body parts will go away. Isn't it? Just small amount of blood, if it is not flowing to one particular part of our body, they won't function. It will become dysfunction. You might have seen that stroke, people, or even slight like variation in the blood flow up to the brain will have headache and other case problems. Right? Did you have some doubt?
How does heart attack happen?
So there are many reasons. Reasons for it. Mainly, this arteries will be blocked with one or the other reason. Mainly arteries, not the veins. Arteries will have a blockage with one or the other reason. You will be knowing the many reasons for it. Maybe cholesterol accumulation, other sudden. Like conviction rises in the heart, the ring, sudden blockage of the blood. So in that way, that should be the reason. But overall, when these two contract, they come closer, and when these two relax, we will have a sound called lap, dub, lap, dub. So that we call one cycle, which is called heartbeat. What is the heartbeat of human being, normal human being?
72.
Yes, 72, exactly. Then what may be the, like per minute it is 72, right? So that, see here, when this contraction of auricles requires, so one heartbeat, one cycle of heartbeat, that is left down, it requires 0.8 seconds. In that, contraction takes 0.3 seconds, relaxation takes 0.5 seconds. That one cycle we call it as heartbeat. So like this, it will keep happening per minute 72 times. After 72 times, it takes rest. If it takes rest for a fraction of a second, we have to be in hospital. Isn't it? So why blood circulation in the different parts is going to be denied? That should not happen. That our heart should be more healthy. So we'll see just how the circulation happens in the one small video. This is how it will be happening in the thoracic cavity, where in the rib cage. We will have see the contraction and relaxation. When it contracts, blood flows from auricle to ventricle. Okay, ventricle will feel depressed it. And again, when ventricle contracts, it won't go back. Instead, it will go into the this aorta and pulmonary veins. This is how it will get it away from the heart. Similar kind of heart. So now just we said heart is situated between the lungs is said, but still very sophisticated protection we have. This will be the rib cage. This is how heart continuously it will keep beating in order to pump the blood from heart to the different parts. So it is called what kind of organ? Pumping organ. Muscular pumping organ. Do you all know? Did you all follow this?
Yes.
Did you all copy the drawing? Regarding this, which you learned in today's class? No doubt? Okay, so in today's class we learned about the structure of heart and its internal structure. Which is the layer protected, covered by the heart?
Pericardia.
Good. What are the total number of chambers in the heart?
Two.
Four. Four is the right answer. Two means parts. Right part, left part. So chambers are four. Which are the chambers which pumps the blood to the away from the heart?
Ventricles.
Yeah, generalized answer. Ventricles. Ventricles pump the blood away from heart, whereas auricles receives the blood from the different parts to the heart. Okay, what is the heartbeat of the normal individual per minute?
72.
It consists of both contraction and relaxation. Clear? Yes. So, I hope you follow, and I will give you a simple homework which might be a question in your mind also. When you go to doctor, usually doctor will find First, they will find out the BP. Usually for the 60 plus or whatever, whenever people are having some health issues, they will check the BP, right? And apart from BP, they will check pulse also and heartbeat also. All these three are related to this heartbeat. The contraction and relaxation of the heart. I want you all to find out, maybe, if it is, it may be a little tough for you to understand, but still this is complete, all the three are related to heartbeat. Contraction and relaxation, okay? Find the difference between, or you can say just collect the information. Right now, collect the information about heartbeat okay and then blood pressure and pulse rate of a healthy human beings. How you can say healthy human? Collect the information about heartbeat, blood pressure and pulse rate of an healthy individual. Current human, yes. Yeah, we'll do it this. It will be interesting to find out so that whenever you see the cardiac report, like report of the heart or anything ECG and that, you can able to identify which is heartbeat, which is pulse rate and which is blood pressure. Thank you all.